अस्सलाम वालेकुम,
वेलकम ग्रेड सेवन। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग ओके। वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ लेक्चर ऑन योर लैंग्वेज पीरियड राइट नाउ। द बुक वी आर यूजिंग इज ऑक्सफोर्ड मॉडर्न इंग्लिश बुक 7। चैप्टर नंबर 1, लाइट इन द नाइट। Words to know are enforced to make sure something is done. Wick, a string in oil or in the middle of a candle that is light, that is lit for burning. Let's start the chapter. London is a major capital city. At night it glows brightly like most modern cities. Before the 1700s, London was much smaller than it is now. On cloudlit, moonlit nights, people would take advantage of the moonlight and go out to socialize, but nighttime in the city could be dangerous. You could trip, fall, and injure yourself. If you fell in the river, you could drown. You could be attacked or robbed by criminals who roamed the streets. You could easily get lost. If people wanted to go out at night, they would have to carry a burning torch or a lamp, or if they were rich enough, pay someone else to carry it. There were many link boys who would, for a small fee, hold a burning torch or lamp ahead of people so that they could see the way through the dark streets. Some of these link boys were dishonest and would rob the people who had employed them and then run off and leave them in the dark. By the early 1700s, busy cities like London and Paris had street lamps in some areas, and Paris, which had street lamps before London, the first street lamps were actually lights placed in the windows of houses. Police enforced a law that said every house had to have a lamp burning in the window all night long. If the lamp went out, people would have to get up to relight it or face being fined. Some people started to offer their services as lamplighters in return for payment. Lamplighters would put up a lamp outside the house and make sure it was lit. The street lamps reassured people and made them feel safer. The authorities realized the benefits they brought and took over the installation and maintenance of them. All over Europe, the use of lamp posts grew. In the 1700s, London grew rapidly and became the world's center of trade, manufacturing, and fashion. Business became important and lights were needed to keep the city working and entertaining in the night. By the late 1700s, London had so many street lamps that visitors to the city were amazed by them. The lamps were fueled by wax or oil that gave off an unpleasant smell and often dripped. Many people were employed as lamp lighters because each lamp had to be lit by hand